Many years ago, a Yu-Gi-Oh! Magazine was created and distributed. And many months ago, that magazine was sent to me. But I know next to nothing about it! Alright you guys, so before I sat down to record this video, I really tried to find any sort of information that I could on this magazine. I went to Google, you know, I Googled different things about, you know, Ghostmasters, it's Ghostmasters Presents, but I Googled, you know, just different things like Ghostmasters and stuff. I Googled the publisher. I went to eBay, guys. I went to eBay to see if I could find any copies of this magazine for sale. I went to Amazon. I did find one Amazon listing, but there's like no picture for what, you know, what magazine it is. Which edition of the magazine it is, you know, which issue, I guess you could say. And to boot this, a listing on Amazon doesn't even have the 2003 extravaganza in the title, which tells me that it's most likely not the magazine that we're looking at today. Matter of fact, the only thing I could really find on this magazine is a random Google image picture. Like, that's it. I don't know if this edition of this magazine is just the rarest one or what, but I was seriously trying to find some more information about this for you guys for this video. But I kind of came up with, you know, came up dry, like I couldn't come up with anything, except for this inside cover here. So this is what's really interesting about this, okay? And I am going to show you the entire magazine, because that is the point of the video, guys. This magazine is incredible, and I'm having to be really, really careful with it, because it is very, very old, but it is a Ghostmasters Presents Yu-Gi-Oh! 2003 Extravaganza magazine that says, Ghostmasters, the world's best unofficial guide to Yu-Gi-Oh! The world's best TCG price guide, which is hilarious to see how much, you know, things have changed. Free giant Yu-Gi-Oh! Fold-out, I mean, which does come out, but the only thing I found interesting, the most useful information, I should say, that I found about this magazine is that it just says, Ghostmasters Presents Yu-Gi-Oh! Issue number 5, 2003, is published 12 times per year by Platinum Publishing Group, LLC. So, 12 times per year. So, there's 12 of these magazines, I think, or however many. I've definitely found different pictures of different magazines from the same distributor and stuff, you know, the same style, but I haven't found this specific issue. I haven't found this specific Yu-Gi-Oh! 2003 extravaganza anywhere. I don't know, like I said, I don't know if this is the rarest one or what, but it is, it's really, really cool. Either way, if it is the rarest one, if it's not the rarest one, it is just amazing. This is one of the coolest things I own, and this is, you know, this is another thing that I got through my Yu-Gi-Oh! Fan mail. You guys sent me some of the coolest stuff I've ever seen, and this is no different, and I just really wanted to sit down and actually show it to you guys, because this is one of the things I look at when I'm getting, you know, writer's block, or I'm feeling, you know, out of touch with the game, or anything like that. I kind of just look through this old Yu-Gi-Oh! Stuff, and it really, really brings me back, so I really wanted to share it with you guys, and let's just get into this. So, I'm not gonna read everything, I'm just gonna kind of show you the amazing old artwork, and I'm gonna turn the pages very, very carefully, not just to show you everything, but because it's very, very old, and I would rather not rip any of the pages or anything. I mean, this was, you know, this was already bent down the middle when I received it, but it's just fine. Like, I didn't care, like, what condition it was in, I was just happy to get it. Like, this thing is so cool. Breaking news, the world of Yu-Gi-Oh! There's the editor's letter. It's time to duel. I mean, I've read this whole thing. It's really funny. It's really cool. But this is the first page I'm going to be stopping at, because it is the top 10 English language Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards, and it has a list right here. So number 1, Raigeki. Number 2, Dark Hole. Number 3, Harpy's Feather Duster. Number 4, Heavy Storm. 5, Change of Heart. Monster Reborn is number 6, which is unbanned now. Swords of Revealing Lights. Number 7, Mirror Force. Number 8, Magic Jammer, number 9, and Pot of Greed, number 10. Pot of Greed, number 10, that should be like number 1 or 2. Pot of Greed, you get to draw 2 cards, it's broken. Oh my gosh, it's still banned to this day for a reason. That is crazy, and that's part of the reason why I wanted to show you guys this magazine, because I think it's hilarious how things have switched. Like, you know, the top 10 Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards, and it's like number 1 and 2 are Raigeki, Dark Hole, but we've had those cards back and legal to us a lot longer than we've had, Monster Reborn back, for example. You know, we still have Heavy Storm banned. We still have Change of Heart Band. We still have Pot of Greed Band. And Pot of Greed is like, Pot of Greed's number 10. It's last on the list. But number one is something we've had unbanned for a long time. That's kind of the point I'm trying to make here. It's really interesting. Yu-Gi-Oh! Ultimate Collectible, The Ultimate Collector. Welcome to Ghostmaster's debut of The Ultimate Collector, where we go deep into the hidden realms of dual monsters to uncover the world's most coveted cards and collectibles on the face of the earth. And this is the second place I'm going to stop, guys, because I have, believe it or not, a second Yu-Gi-Oh! Magazine. I really do have a second Yu-Gi-Oh! Magazine, and I have a whole other video planned for that one. So that was something I was going to mention earlier, but I just remembered to mention it now. And I have a whole video planned for this other one, and you guys are really, really going to love it. I just wanted to show one magazine at a time, though. I wanted everyone to just look at this and just enjoy it, you know, because this is so cool. It's one of the coolest things I have. I'm being completely serious. But Pharaoh's Servant, the new deck. Oh my gosh. This is like right when Pharaoh's Servant came out. You get to see, this gives you like a preview of all the new cards, what was new, you know. Jinzo, of course, was like, you know, just came out and it's just a, you know, a boss monster. I mean, just a truly a boss monster. I mean, it stops all traps. Jinzo is just an amazing card. Nobleman to cross out, you know, really good in GOAT format, really good. Gets flip effect monsters in general. Pharaoh's Servant was just a really good set. I mean, if you look at all these cards like Cold Wave and stuff, Thousand Eyes Restrict, there's just a lot of cards not only, you know, played, still played to this day in some cases, Imperial Order right there, but there's, you know, there's a lot of nostalgic cards and just, you know, that's really what I'm getting at. There's a lot of cards played, you know, to this day in this set, and then there's just a lot of nostalgic cards. There's like, you know, and just looking at, you know, just the art on all these classic cards is just something I also like to do. But the Ghostmasters exclusive price guide and checklist for all Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards, man. So this right here is something else I wanted to show you guys. This price guide, though. Oh my gosh, Mystical Elf, $2.10, SDY. That is crazy, and that's the common one. That's not the LOB Super Rare. That is SDY, $2 for the common. Oh my gosh. Like, how many Mystical Elves do you guys have in your commons now? I know I have probably like 50, and I know that for a fact because I keep all my 2002 format stuff all in one place, so I know I have a bunch of Mystical Elves. It's insane. It's just really funny, like, looking at all this. And Summon Skull, $3 for Summon Skull. Dark Magician, guys, $24. Starter Deck Yugi, Dark Magician, $24. I'm just going to go through here and see the most expensive ones. Soul Exchange, $10. Wow. Starter Deck Yugi, Soul Exchange, $10. Blue Eyes White Dragon from LOB, of course. No, Starter Deck Kaiba, wow. Wow. So that started at Kaiba Blue Eyes, $28, guys. $28. That means the LOB Blue Eyes has got to be super expensive. Where's that at? There it is. LOB, $45. I knew it. And then the Trihorn from LOB, $37.50. That is just nuts. And what other expense? Do we have any other expensive cards? $10. Flute of Summoning Dragon for $10. Flute of Summoning Dragon. And Lord of D for $8.45. That is insane. That is just nuts. And then Red Eyes Black Dragon. Ooh, so how much does Red Eyes Black Dragon go for? Red Eyes LOB, Red Eyes. Whoa, hey, that's a misprint. Or is this like a listing for a misprint? LOB, Red Eyes Blue Dragon, $50. Is that like a misprint? Does that make it worth $50 because it's a misprint? Like, or what? $26 for a poly, $15 for the super rare Mystical Elf back in the day. Raigeki, $22. Dark Hole, $15. Let's see what else we have. Where's the Red Eyes Black Dragon? So, the Red Eyes Black Dragon, this must be a, oh man, I've never noticed this before, for real. Yeah, ultra rare. So, Red Eyes Blue Dragon, it was supposed to be Red Eyes Black Dragon. That's a misprint in this magazine. That is just nuts. I've never noticed that, for real. That's crazy. $50, though. $50, and then here's Metal Raiders stuff. That's just sick. That's so crazy. Swords of Revealing Light, $22. Oh my gosh. I need to pass all this. I need to pass all this. Like, this is just ridiculous looking at all these prices. But this, here's the thing it talks about on the front cover, where it's like, you know, Yu-Gi-Oh! Fold Out. I think this is what it's talking about. You know, this is something, you know, this is not stapled in anymore. But, or maybe this isn't the fold out and this is supposed to remain stapled in. I'm not sure. I'm really not sure. I mean, I can't even tell you the last time I bought a magazine, guys. I'm not even sure how the magazines even work anymore. Like, I can't even tell you. But let's keep on trucking here. So this is just talking about, skill had a magic. What is this? Imperial Decree? I'm not sure what they're talking about here. I'm not sure what they are talking about. This is really cool, though. This Yu-Gi-Oh! This is like, I mean, just this is what I'm talking about, guys. Like, this really cool, just really nostalgic, old-school artwork. I'm not doing a very good job of keeping this in the magazine. So you know what? I'm just going to set this aside for now. In the cover, I'm having to be, like, really careful. I'm actually being really rough with it right now in comparison to how I normally treat it. I'm trying to keep... And look at this. The video arcade. Konami brings Yu-Gi-Oh! To life. Dark duels. Stories, the eternal duelist soul. Wow, this is just, I mean, like I said, guys, this is seriously something I look through all the time, by freshen up, I use it to, keep me into Yu-Gi-Oh! I mean, because sometimes, you know, being a Yu-Gi-Tuber and, like, doing this all the time, you kind of get burnt out on it, you know, even though, I will say that, my love for the game keeps me in. I'm glad that I'm able to do this all the time and not absolutely hate the game, which is really, really great, but sometimes you still get burnt out, you know, sometimes you really do still get burnt out doing this all the time, and it's just really nostalgic stuff like this that just brings me, you know, brings me right back. And this is what's really cool. This is another place I wanted to stop at. Yu-Gi-Oh! Quiz. I haven't filled it in. There is a part that's filled in here in a second. I'll show you guys. The previous owner of this, you know, who sent it to me, must have filled it out. But this is, like, really cool. And the first episode, Yugi and his friends go back to his house where Yugi and his grandpa show them a super rare card. What card is it? Blank. And the card is Blue Eyes White Dragon, of course. Episode 2. And question 2. In episode 13, Yugi battles Bakura for a prize of winning all of his friends' souls back. What is Bakura playing for? He is playing for the Millennium Puzzle, if I would recall. So, so this is just, like, really cool, you know, quizzes from the show and stuff. I wish they still did stuff like this. This would be way cool to have. The Master Duelist of Aspects to Play, understanding how to use chain reactions in the Yu-Gi-Oh! TCG. So, this is, showing you guys how to, showing people how to resolve chains and stuff. And this is the next place I want to stop, the Yu-Gi-Oh! Scramble. This is, like, I'm not going to go over all of them, but it's like, you know, you see these in magazines and stuff, and it's like replacing words, so, like, you know, jumbling up words and seeing if you can guess them, I should say. So, like, spells, trap, and some of these I actually don't know, and I have it. That one's magic, dice. I don't know. And there's actually still some of these I haven't figured out for real, but don't ruin them for me, okay? Every now and then I kind of want to look through this and try to figure it out. So then this one's already solved. This is like a word search thing they have in here. What are the words, though? So conjure, dice, a spell. So I guess some of the words. Oh, no. Oh, so is some of the words over here? No. Okay, that's fine. I was like, oh no, if they're the same thing, I'm like, oh, that would suck, but they're not. I'm glad that I'm just, like, not noticing things. I'm gonna ruin what brings me back, guys. That would not be good. That would not be good at all. So the reader's playing field, reader's art that makes the grade. This is, like, you know, fan art and stuff. And I actually see this kind of stuff all the time. I'm so thankful for that. You guys send me some of the coolest fan art, you know, the coolest stuff in the mail. You really do. And then I see this all the time on YGO Amino and stuff. I actually go on there sometimes. Also, just to kind of, like, you know, get in touch with the community and everything, keep in touch with everybody. And people there draw some of the coolest stuff I've ever seen, too. It's actually just nuts. It's really cool, you know, how talented Yu-Gi-Oh! Players are, and just, it's nuts. It's nuts to me, because I can't even draw a circle. I mean, my girlfriend is just, you guys have seen the stuff she's drawn, and it's incredible, and I can't draw a circle, guys. Like, I'm pretty, without a computer, I'm pretty useless, let me tell you. And at the end, they even have, like, this little survey here. Take the Ghostmasters survey. All right, readers, here's your chance to be part of the team. But does the team even exist anymore? That's the question. Where did you buy your copy of Ghostmaster Presents Yu-Gi-Oh? I didn't buy it. It was sent to me. What sections of this magazine did you like the most? I liked the whole thing. What would you like to see in this magazine that it doesn't have? I don't think it's missing anything. Probably newer stuff, but you know, this is really, really old. And here it is, the back. Oh, a collector's edition. Okay, so maybe that's why. I actually forgot that it's a collector's edition on the back. So maybe that's why this one's harder to find or something like that. But guys, I just really wanted to share this with you because, like, you know, like I've said a couple times now, this is one of the things that, you know, just when I look at it, you know, there's certain things in Yu-Gi-Oh! You guys probably have something similar. You know, you just look at it and it just, it brings brings you back. It makes you love the game, and like it, you feel that nostalgia rise up in you and stuff. And this is one of those things for me, guys. Not only does this have just some amazing art and stuff, and just, you know, old cards and everything else, old school Yu-Gi-Oh that you would love, but it was also sent to me by a fan. So because of that, this is one of the most sentimental items that I own, and I just want to thank everybody for watching this video. And I would love, love, love to hear what you guys think is the most nostalgic in Yu-Gi-Oh. In other words, what is the most nostalgic thing in Yu-Gi-Oh to you? I would love to hear down in the comment section. But until next time, guys, be sure to dick slap that like button and subscribe.
Subscribe!